This is GTV. Powered up. In the year 2000X, technology has become a facet of everyday life. Robots have become advanced and integrated into our lives. The people of this era live a peaceful life in harmony with their creations. At the laboratory of Dr. Light, inventor of many robots in use, he and his household helpers, Rock and Roll, prepare for dinner as the good doctor finishes up a day's work. When suddenly, a distress call from the chief of electricity. Dr. Light's robots have started malfunctioning, causing havoc across the city. Gutsman is tearing up concrete. Fireman has set everything around him ablaze. Cutman has caused damage with his blades. Iceman has frozen the resort district. Many of his other robots are going wild everywhere. Dr. Light panics, not knowing what to do. Rock, having a strong sense of justice, volunteers to restore peace to the city. But Dr. Light reminds Rock that he was built not for that specification and could never stand a chance out there. Rock begs Dr. Light to rebuild him so that he may fight. That night, Dr. Light built a new casing for Rock and rewires his circuitry. With a flip of a switch, the doctor turns Rock back online. With jumping boots and an arm cannon called the Mega Buster, Rock has successfully been upgraded into Mega Man. Dr. Light wishes him well, and Mega Man begins his journey to stop the out-of-control robots. Dr. Light wonders what could be causing this disaster. How and why could all of his inventions malfunction all at once? Meanwhile, at a nearby construction site, Gutsman is tearing down buildings, sending concrete and bricks everywhere. MegaMan demands Gutsman stop now or face the Mega Buster. Gutsman refuses and sends his minions to attack. MegaMan fights them off while Gutsman looks on, impressed. Mega Man moves on but is suddenly confronted with the Big Eye, who lands right on Mega Man. He's able to escape thanks to the jump boots and delivers a rapid-fire attack to the Big Eye, causing it to explode. The door to Guts Man's chamber opens. Mega Man goes inside to meet Guts Man face to face. Guts Man hurls a concrete cube at Mega Man, who falls to the ground in pain, in shock of the immense power he has just felt. Gutsman raises another cube to finish the job. But Mega Man pleads with him to listen, that Dr. Light can fix him, if he can explain what happened. Gutsman refuses, telling Mega Man that the evil robots are going to take over the world. Mega Man, with no choice left, fires his Mega Buster at Gutsman to take him down. The two exchange attacks as Mega Man fights on bravely against the falling concrete all around him. Mega Man fires the Mega Buster once more, with a direct hit, defeating Gutsman and sending him crashing to the ground. Mega Man, using his scanner vision, inspects the circuitry of Gutsman to find a small chip inside. He calls Dr. Light via his radio helmet to alert him of what has transpired and what he has found. Dr. Light knows immediately. This chip came from Dr. Wily. Dr. Light explains to Mega Man that Dr. Wily is dangerous and mad. It could only mean trouble from here on out. Mega Man asks Dr. Light, "Who is Dr. Wily? How do you know of him?" Dr. Light tells a story he has kept from Rock and Roll all their lives. Years ago, Dr. Light and Dr. Wily knew each other at the Institute of Robot Technology. Though friends at the time, they soon had a falling out over the use of robots and their powers. Dr. Wily felt that with the power of robots, he and Dr. Light could conquer the world, but Dr. Light disagreed, saying robots should only be used for peace. After their falling out, Dr. Wily left the Institute, and Dr. Light never heard from him again. Until now. The idea of robots programmed for evil angered Mega Man, and right then and there he vowed never to stop until Dr. Wily is brought to justice. However, he still had a city full of malfunctioning robots to deal with. Mega Man takes the power arm from Guts Man's circuitry and moves on. It's been over 24 hours since the robots started to rebel. The streets were abandoned as people sought safety from danger. Mega Man encounters a few enemies who catch him off guard, and after securing the area, Mega Man yells out to Dr. Wily to show himself and come out of hiding. Just then, he hears someone approach. Cut Man. He takes his rolling cutter and flings it right at Mega Man. The strike knocks him straight to the ground. Cut Man says that with the help of Dr. Wily, the robots will rule the world and cover the world in darkness for years to come. Mega Man assesses the situation. If Cut Man's power is in his rolling cutter, then he'll be open to an attack after it's released. Mega Man powers up the part he took from Guts Man, and with the super arm, pulls a concrete cube from the ground, tossing it squarely at Cut Man. The attack drains much of his power, and Cut Man knows immediately that Mega Man has harnessed Guts Man's special powers. Cut Man stands up and prepares a rolling cutter attack, but Mega Man gets the best of him, hurling another cube quickly, and this one does the job, defeating Cut Man. As Mega Man stands over Cut Man's lifeless body, he apologizes, but says Cut Man's rolling cutter attack will now belong to him. He equips it and tells Cut Man that after Dr. Wily is defeated, he will bring him back to Dr. Light and repair him. Unbeknownst to Mega Man, the other robot masters are looking on. They discuss what to do next, as with Cut Man now gone, soon Mega Man will reach them and Dr. Wily. Electman steps up to the challenge, saying that he will be the one who puts an end to this. The other robots say nothing and let Electman go right ahead. At the electrical plant, Mega Man opens the gates and enters. Inside, he faces disappearing platforms, roving drones covered in spikes, and live electricity, posing dangers at each turn. Mega Man tried to jump through, but mistimes and receives a shock, and is sent falling back to the bottom of the plant floor. Timing is the key here, as Mega Man studies the rhythms of the traps and takes a leap all the way up to the top, this time. Climbing up to the roof, there are still a few guard robots to deal with. Mega Man hangs onto the ladder and fires away. On the roof, he comes face to face with Electman, who says he will enjoy being the one to put an end to the rebellion against Dr. Wily. Mega Man changes his power to the super arm, lifting a cube out of the ground. But before he can throw it, Electman attacks with a surge of raw electricity. The cube crumbles to dust right in Mega Man's hands. He ducks for cover and switches to the rolling cutter. Mega Man realizes that certain weapons will affect robots in different ways. He sends the rolling cutter back to Electman one more time, severing him in half, defeating him. Mega Man is torn about having to fight his fellow robots, who were all built by Dr. Light. He questions why Electman and the others had to turn to evil and force Mega Man to do this. Then he remembers that this is all the fault of Dr. Wily. An incoming message from Dr. Light transmits through Mega Man's helmet. The doctor instructs him to head to the resort area immediately. Iceman has taken over, freezing the entire island. Mega Man swims to the island, which he can see far off in the horizon. Along the way, Pepes are putting up an offense in the water, all the way to the shore. Mega Man submerges for an underwater fight, hoping to slow them down. Upon reaching the island, Mega Man finds the evacuation tower, wherein the whole population has entered to avoid the freezing temperatures outside. But the tower is heavily guarded and is some 20 stories tall. How can Mega Man enter? Cleverly, he jumps on top of some of the footholders, using them as jumping platforms. He makes it to the top, then slides down a chute, to find hundreds of people huddled together, waiting for a rescue. One child asks his mother to take him home. She says that she can't, but maybe this robot has come to save them. MegaMan says that he has indeed come to help. Just then, Iceman slides down the same chute, introduces himself, and says that with his great ice powers, he will freeze everyone right where they stand. MegaMan says no way. Iceman must be stopped, and it's up to him to do it. Iceman answers back, saying MegaMan will submit to the power of the Ice Crusher. And with a triple attack, MegaMan is frozen solid. The people watch on in shock as they see the hopes of their rescue fade. Iceman stands over the frozen body of MegaMan and yells out to the people to witness the might of the Ice Crusher. And with such power, he will help Dr. Wily conquer the world. MegaMan, still on the ground motionless, begins to steam up. A sound starts to emanate from his Mega Buster. The ice covering MegaMan then shatters, and a pulse of the Thunder Beam shoots Iceman, sending him across the room. The people cheer as MegaMan gains advantage in the fight. Iceman recomposes himself and sends out another wave of the Ice Crusher, which MegaMan narrowly dodges. He then sends a high-charged Thunder Beam with a power of 1 million volts, dead center through Iceman. The people celebrate and surround MegaMan, thanking him for his bravery, as they soon will be free to go home. Unknown to MegaMan, one flying Pepe makes an escape back to Dr. Wily to inform him of the situation.
Mega action. Mega adventure. Mega excitement. Mega Man comes to Sega Genesis for the first time in Mega Man, The Wily Wars. This much-anticipated Genesis incarnation of Mega Man, based on the best-selling titles for the Nintendo Entertainment System, features robots from Mega Man's first three encounters with the villainous Dr. Wily. With dozens of worlds to explore and nasty bosses to vanquish, tons of exciting new weapons, and the big new addition of Rush the Robo-Dog, Mega Man, The Wily Wars.
As the people leave the evacuation center, Dr. Light appears looking for Mega Man. They're happy to see each other, but Dr. Light scolds him for being too careless and facing near destruction too many times. He also presents Mega Man with a new upgrade, the Magnet Beam. With this, Mega Man can create his own platforms to climb up on, for a short time. The director of the evacuation procedures comes to Dr. Light and Mega Man to inform them that there is trouble down at the industrial complex, as Fireman has been seen there, causing explosions. With enough high-pressure containment units there, it could be a major disaster for the city. Mega Man heads off in search of Fireman, wasting no time. He finds pulsing flame jets, living fire. For many of the obstacles, the Mega Buster isn't any good, so he changes to the newly acquired Ice Crusher, which puts out the fire every time. Some jumps are impossible, and so the Magnet Beam comes in handy. In the center of the industrial complex, Mega Man finds an impassable wall of fire, which he is able to turn into a solid frozen pillar, thanks to the Ice Crusher. Then, across the massive industrial complex core, stands Fireman. He has one message for Mega Man. He will die. Mega Man says no, he will not die, nor will he kill Fireman. Only return him to Dr. Light so that he may become repaired and used for good once again. Fireman ignores the pleas of Mega Man and lets loose with his signature weapon, the Firestorm. Mega Man jumps out of the way and knows the only way to fight fire is with ice. A direct hit with the Ice Crusher sends Fireman to his knees. Nice try, says Fireman, but you don't realize that energy is finite. What? Says Mega Man. It's empty. That's right, says Fireman. You used all the ice energy getting here. Now it's my Firestorm versus the Mega Buster. Fireman attacks, as does Mega Man, but the Mega Buster can't defeat Fireman in just one hit. Mega Man times out his attacks to deliver enough damage slowly, and after several hits, defeats Fireman. With Fireman gone, Mega Man runs to the last remaining robot master, Bomb Man. All remaining robots swarm Mega Man as he makes his way across the city. Mega Man can fight through, but it takes time as there are too many in the way. After clearing as many as he can, he runs across a bridge but is hit in the back by a stray shot. The shooter, Sniper Joe, challenges Mega Man to a fight, one he says he can't lose thanks to his shield. As they battle high above the ground, a camera, remotely controlled by Dr. Wily, watches on. "Ah, so this is Mega Man," says Wily, "the robot built by my rival." Using the camera, Wily scans and analyzes Mega Man, studying his strengths and weaknesses for the battle they will undoubtedly have. As Wily watches from afar, he's shocked to see Mega Man defeat Sniper Joe. Wily sends in Bomb Man with a surprise attack. Bomb Man rushes in with hyper bombs, sending several Mega Man's way. In a cloud of smoke, Mega Man is lost, unable to find his direction, nor see Bomb Man. Just then, Bomb Man appears, right in Mega Man's face, and sets off another hyper bomb. Mega Man hides in a corner to get his bearings, and he knows a few shots of the firestorm will cause Bomb Man's bombs to go off before he can launch them. Just then, a screeching, blaring noise can be heard behind Mega Man and grows louder. Dr. Wily, in his hovercraft! As Wily flies away, Mega Man curses him for being the one who brought such a panic upon the city and vows to stop him. Following the direction of Dr. Wily's hovercraft, Mega Man makes his way to Wily's compound. Twin pyramids located far beyond the edges of the city. The perimeter is already heavily guarded, waiting for Mega Man's arrival. Mega Man can't seem to find a door to open to get inside the pyramids, but uses the super arm to move some bricks and force his way inside. Once there, flame jets block the way, as do even more robots who intend to stop Mega Man before he gets any further. Wily watches on from afar, in his lair, in the center of the pyramid, as Mega Man moves closer and closer. Wily is both impressed and frightened by Mega Man's endurance and spirit to thwart his plans. Wily says to himself that obviously, a robot built by Dr. Light would be hard to deal with. But once that Mega Man is out of the way, the world will bow to the world's greatest genius, and Wily will finally get the recognition he deserves. To Wily, Dr. Light is not the great genius everyone thinks he is, and that all his accomplishments and accolades are for naught, gaining them only because he was good friends with the scientific community. Only after Dr. Light is stripped of his titles, when Wily conquers the world, will he know the feeling Wily has felt all this time, of being number two. Only one thing stands in his way. Mega Man continues through the pyramid searching for Wily, only to come face to face with the Yellow Devil, a creation of Wily's that is part robot and part natural granite that can separate and rejoin across distances. Wily appears on a monitor greeting Mega Man formally for the first time and begs him to take on his creation. Mega Man fights the Yellow Devil, but his attacks do nothing. The Yellow Devil moves across the room, hurling itself at Mega Man as a volatile projectile. The damage is too intense for Mega Man as he is left drained of energy at the feet of the Yellow Devil. Wily instructs the Devil to go in for the kill and destroy Mega Man at once. Mega Man, left without any choice, consumes a 1-Up capsule, which recharges his energy, giving him another chance to fight. Mega Man tries the Hyper Bombs and Rolling Cutter. Neither work. He tries the Firestorm. Some of the flame hits the Yellow Devil in the eye, exposing its only weak point. Now realizing how to take the Devil down, Mega Man waits for its next reconstitution and attacks dead on with the Thunder Beam. Wily watches on as his creation is vaporized. He then gets on the mic and declares a yellow alert. All attack robots in the second pyramid are to move in and stop Mega Man. With the first pyramid cleared, Mega Man moves on to the second. A swarm of bladers stand in the way. A few rounds of the firestorm clear them easily. But then Mega Man is taken aback, in complete shock at what he sees before him. Elec Man and Cut Man, rebuilt and ready for revenge. Fighting each of these robot masters on their own was daunting enough, but now Mega Man has to take on both of them at the same time. Mega Man recalls that each robot has its own weakness, and now that he possesses all weapons needed for victory, takes out Cut Man first with the Mega Buster, and then Elec Man with the Rolling Cutter. With nowhere to go but down, Mega Man jumps through a pit to find himself in a strange room with colorful, glowing walls. Suddenly, a bright light flashes, and a strange machine descends from the ceiling, zapping Mega Man. Wily appears on one of the panels in the room to announce that this machine has cloned Mega Man, and now he must survive a battle against himself. An impossible task, Wily adds, as every thought and action will be exactly the same. Mega Man begins the fight, but with each jump and attack, the clone responds in kind at that exact same time. Wily looks on and laughs, as he knows Mega Man will eventually be defeated. There's no escape whether he fights or not. Mega Man knows that this strategy is futile, as each hit that he exchanges with the clone will eventually lead to both of their destructions. Even an upgraded weapon like the Thunder Beam delivers the same result. Wily tells Mega Man that he will lose. Mega Man gets back to his feet and says that he will never lose. Mega Man knows that the clone will copy every move, but also moves freely. So, if he moves counter to the clone, it might create an opening for an attack. Mega Man sets off a blast of the Thunder Beam and immediately jumps out of the way. The clone robot sets off his own blast, but had no time to jump, receiving the shock of the Thunder Beam and exploding. Dr. Wily can't believe it, and one less obstacle stands in Mega Man's way. Mega Man continues searching for Dr. Wily inside his twin pyramid compound when he enters an underwater chamber and encounters a strange homing beacon sealed in a bubble, charging directly at him. Mega Man takes the bricks found in the chamber and, using the super arm, takes aim at the beacon. After destroying it, another one appears, and then another. With all of the bricks gone, Mega Man switches to the hyper bomb to remove the last beacon. Climbing out of the chamber, he meets a rebuilt bomb man at the top of the ladder. At least this time he's alone, says Mega Man, as he sends out a firestorm attack to Bomb Man, incinerating him. On the next level, he meets Fireman, and then Guts Man again. Knowing their weaknesses has made the battle easier, though still heartbreaking, as Mega Man is forced to fight his own robotic brothers. Mega Man has made it to the core of the second pyramid, and now, finally, stands face to face with Dr. Wily. Wily, piloting the Wily machine, says to Mega Man that it was admirable of him to reach this point, but that this will be the final battle, and the loser will be Mega Man. An intense blast fires out from the cannon of the Wily machine. Mega Man jumps out of the way and returns fire with the Mega Buster, shattering the domed cockpit of the Wily machine. With a blast of the Thunder Beam, a shockwave is sent through both Wily and the machine, destroying it in a giant flash. Mega Man cheers with excitement. He has won the battle! Dr. Wily's plans have been stopped. Wily survived the battle, however, and Mega Man rushes to his aid, asking if he is all right. Wily is confused and asks Mega Man, "Why do you help me?" Mega Man says that in defeat, he can see that there is no longer evil in the heart of Dr. Wily, and that he can be redeemed. If he is truly a genius, says Mega Man, Dr. Wily should show the world how, by creating robots to be used for good purposes. For peace, not war. Mega Man leaves the compound, as his final words to Dr. Wily are that when the next time they meet, he hopes it's as a friend, not an enemy. Hopeful to see what robots Wily may create until that day comes. Outside the pyramid, Mega Man looks out upon the city, now at peace. It was time to return home. Roll and Dr. Light are waiting. Mega Man takes off his helmet, saying he doesn't need it anymore. The battle is over. Mega Man can now return home and be Rock once again.